30 million years ago, in what is now Pakistan, the shadow of the largest animal of that time covered the horizon and the landscape resembled a savannah. This animal was a parasaran and one of the largest mammals that ever existed. Its body shape was similar to that of a giraffe, but giraffes were supposed to evolve in 20 million years, and even though it was very big, it had nothing to do with elephants. In fact, it was most similar to rhinoceroses. However, his skull probably carried a hook. The reason is that while the five species of rhinoceros that are alive today are very similar and are on the verge of extinction, the larger family that included the rhinoceros was once much larger and more mature, and was spread far north than today and survived in a colder climate. In this program, we take a look at the evolution of the rhinoceros. The first fossilized ancestor of the rhinoceros was a small creature called Hyracdon, which lacked horns and was about the size of a pig. About 50 million years ago, he lived in North America during the Eocene period, when the global temperature was much higher than today. So their American habitat must have been a mass forest. At this point in history, the closest living relatives of rhinoceroses are horses and tapirs, whose ancestors were hard to tell apart in the early Eocene. This is because they all live in the same way and have less time to diversify in different places. But this is also a general law of evolution that the more you go back, the more similar animals become because they are closer to each other. Horses, rhinoceroses, and tapirs are the only living descendants of a group of animals called perissodactyls, which are classified by the fact that they have an odd number of fingers. And they balance most of their weight on their middle finger. Compared to most hoofed animals known as artiodactyls, they distribute more weight on their two middle fingers. Today, artiodactyls are much more numerous than perissodactyls, and they are large herbivores that inhabit most ecosystems. But around 25 to 45 million years ago, the perissodactyls were much more numerous. For example, there is a group of perissodactyls called chalicotters that have claws and some of them have a gorilla-like body shape with front legs longer than their hind legs. But like all perissodactyls, their oldest ancestors were small four-legged hunter-gatherers similar to Hyracodon. Perissodactyls also include a group of prehistoric animals called brontophora, which are very similar to rhinoceroses. However, this similarity was only due to their convergent evolution and in fact they were closer to horses and even much older. They lived in the Eocene period and became extinct about 35 million years ago, which was the period when rhinoceros began to evolve. This was the beginning of an era called the Oligocene, roughly between the present and the extinction of the non-avian dinosaurs. Dinosaurs have been extinct for a long time and now they are ruling mammals and have a lot of punishment. But the big mammal families that we know today rarely evolved and instead the land habitats were full of different but similar mammals. Cats and dogs have just evolved and are small and definitely not among the most powerful hunters. Instead, the largest carnivorous species are known as criidans, a group of mammals that have many of the same hunting characteristics as cats and dogs, such as retractable sharp claws. At this point in history, the largest mammals were a group of long-snout rhinoceroses called parasaratarians. But it was not only Parasaratrium, and in fact the whole family of rhinoceros became significantly more numerous during this period, and they are even more numerous than they are today. At some point in their evolution, the rhinoceros family split. Real rhinoceroses are known as Rhinoceratidae and long-necked rhinoceros as Paraceratodi. First, Paraceratodus had a relatively large size. The first paraceratoids found in fossils lived in China, and they were almost the same size as a horse, both in terms of height and size. Most species of the Paraceratodian were about this size. From a horse about the size of a wild deer, but later in the Oligocene, a member of this group evolved and became the largest land animal since the extinction of non-avian dinosaurs. Paraceratrium was first associated with rhinoceroses due to teeth and parts of the brain found in Pakistan. And when it was discovered, it was thought to be just basically a rhinoceros. Of course, with a huge amount to justify the size of the discovered fossils. Almost immediately, these images were revised to an animal with a longer neck and legs due to the discovery of some longer vertebrae and limb material. For most of the 19th century, there was a debate between depicting Paraceratrium as a truly massive 20-ton beast with the body of a rhinoceros or as a leaner, giraffe-like mammal. According to some new materials discovered in Russia, there were. The head of Paraceratrium, as first described, was not that of a rhinoceros. Their nasals were very narrow. Their nasal canals were pushed back much further and the space for muscle tendons in their faces was much larger than needed to control a normal mouth. All this suggests that Paraceratrium probably had some kind of hopper. It means that his head may have been more like a tapir than a rhinoceros. The latest images of Paraceratrium are somewhere between a really huge animal and similar to a rhinoceros and a creature similar to a giraffe. This means that Paraceratrium probably resembled a fat horse with a hopper. About 10 years after the discovery of the first Paraceratrium, a partial skull was excavated from the remains of the specimens, and it was estimated that the existing skull was about 1.3 meters long, which is almost twice the length of the skull of a modern rhinoceros and even bigger than the skull of an African elephant. However, it is not known how long this skull was carried above the ground because no evidence of the spine of this animal was found. But the hand and legs of Paraceratrium are very well represented in several different specimens. Magnification of the bones of the largest Paraceratrium species found shows that it could be to 5 meters tall at the shoulder, which is taller than an African elephant. The first true rhinoceroses in the fossil record first appeared a little before 30 million years ago in the very early Oligocene. And they live next to parasaratriums, sometimes in the same habitats. But they are often much smaller, and many of their species are even smaller than modern rhinos. One of the oldest known rhinoceroses was Mammals, which had a lighter body structure than modern rhinoceroses and was about the size of a pig. Instead of having their tusks back to back, their tusks were side by side, a feature shared by all the earliest and most primitive true rhinoceroses known. Rhinoceros lived in North America, and their fossils are often found in large groups, indicating that they may have lived in large herds. These smaller rhinoceros became extinct about 20 million years ago. But the larger North American rhinos, which probably lived in a similar way to modern rhinos, they survived until about 5 million years ago, when all rhinos on the continent died out. Today's living rhinos first appeared in Asia about 20 million years ago. And about 2 million years ago, all the more ancient species of rhinos that existed before became extinct, and the remaining rhinos are now similar to the living rhinos of today. In addition to the 5 living species of rhinoceros, several other species survived, but they became extinct at the end of the Ice Age. Especially the woolly rhinoceros, as well as Elasmotherium, a real giant who lived in Asia during the Ice Age. And he was taller than a human and weighed as much as an Asian elephant. The woolly rhinoceros was very close to living species of rhinoceros today, but the Elasmotherium was much more distant. But because they lived in a similar climate to the woolly rhinoceros, they think they might have had wool too. So, rhinoceroses are very diverse, fill different places and have different body shapes, while also having more dispersion and going much further north than where they go today. Currently, there are only 5 species of rhinoceros left, and 4 of those 5 species are in danger of extinction. We have reached the end of this program. If you like this video, please like it to support us, and if you are interested in the world of animals, subscribe to the animal channel of the zoologist and press the bell button to be notified as soon as new videos are uploaded.